In this video, I'll show you how to create a perfect project with Bolt using the best AI development workflow you will ever find. With the help of Bolt, we will build a full-fledged project using advanced AI dev tools like Cursor, Cline, and Aider. We'll cover everything from project setup to production, so stay tuned. Bolt is fantastic for non-coders. It lets anyone create something from scratch with just a few prompts, which wasn't possible until recently with AI dev tools. While Bolt makes coding fun and easy, there are limitations. The cost can add up, and sometimes the output isn't exactly what we're looking for. Plus, Bolt often requires repetitive work, which could be time-consuming. A big downside is how Bolt makes whole file changes, affecting code quality. Additionally, it lacks integration with proven tools like GitHub, which limits productivity and scalability. Now let me quickly show you the best Bolt-based development workflow. We're still going to use Bolt, but we will use other tools to make our project successful. Here's our workflow. We will start a project using Bolt. After creating the starter project using Bolt, we will create a GitHub repository right away. And then we will use other AI tools like Claude AI or ChatGPT to generate our software development plan. Afterwards, we will select AI dev tools. It could be Cursor, which is a complete IDE, and it's powerful because it's a fork of Visual Studio Code. However, it requires technical skills and can still be costly. We can also choose Cline, which is UI friendly and beginner friendly Visual Studio Code extension. The downside is it can also be costly. Or Aider, which is a flexible and powerful cost-effective tool that's very effective for surgical or micro changes. I will show you what I mean later. However, the downside is it requires some basic command line skills. You can use any combination of these tools. You don't have to select one. And then we'll go to the continuous improvement cycle. Real projects requires continuous improvement. So that's why we still need to use our AI dev tools to add new features, to test those features. While testing the old features that's already been proven to be working. And then we will deploy it, we will continue monitoring it, and then we will scale and brainstorm on how to monetize it. So this is our complete AI development workflow based on Bolt. Now let me copy the outline of the tutorial that I have asked ChatGPT to generate earlier. And then I will copy it to Claude so that Claude will be able to generate our component architecture based on the tutorial outline. I also asked Claude to generate the user flow diagram like you can see here. It will be helpful in our development later. Afterwards, I also asked Claude to generate a UI prototype. This is just the general layout of our UI. We will include this screenshot later. However, I cannot maximize the view of this artifact due to Claude's limitation. Fortunately, there's this publish feature of Claude where I can publish and click on it, and then I can view it in full screen. I can even share it with others. Now let us start with our initial project using Bolt. I'm going to use this prompt, and then I will paste in the general layout that I have asked Claude to generate earlier. Then I will click execute. Let me zoom out a bit. Now it is creating our app. Once our app is working, we're going to link it immediately to GitHub. This will let us track changes and work on it in a more productive way. It says here that there's an entry error. Let's ask Bolt to fix this for us. We'll copy it in our clipboard, and I will say, I cannot see anything. Maybe you missed some files. So now it's creating the missing files. But it looks like it's still missing some files that is required for it to run. So let's ask Bolt again. It's now creating the missing files. It took me 3 attempts to set this up, but now Bolt was finally managed to make this work. And it followed the screenshot that we provided very, very well. This is good. So now I will download the project to save keep it. And then I will click on open in StackBlitz. We just need to use StackBlitz this way in order to create a repository very quickly. So I will click on create repository. I will name this GitHub Interactive Tutorial. I will make sure not to click on make this repository private, otherwise it won't be possible for Bolt to open this repository later. So make sure to not set it in private. You can set it in private later if you want using your GitHub account. Now let's see what we have here in our GitHub, and you can see that the initial commit is just now. Now our code is saved in our GitHub repository. So whatever happens to my computer, I have my code saved in the cloud. Okay, let me go back in StackBlitz. We don't have any use for StackBlitz anymore because there's no AI dev tools here. You can see that the open in Bolt is now gone. So we will close this StackBlitz window and let's go back to Bolt. We will first copy our GitHub repository URL, and in order to load it in Bolt, we will just simply paste it here like so and click enter. And then Bolt will reload our project from our GitHub repository. Notice it doesn't have chat history here, and I intentionally reloaded Bolt so that our chat history will be cleared. It will also save us some token. So you might be wondering, how can I change my code outside Bolt but still use Bolt as my development tool? So what can we do is we will clone our GitHub repository locally. You can use GitHub desktop or open it with Visual Studio, but I'm going to use SSH and I will clone it by a command line, as you can see here. Now I can open it in my IDE like Cursor. So I'm using Cursor here with a bunch of other extensions. Okay, now I'm going to use the component structure that I have asked Claude to generate earlier. So I will ask Bolt to generate all of this and add some placeholder contents. I will download this file and then I'm going to create a new folder in our project here. I will call it Dev Specs and I will drag the file into that folder. And then I'm going to push this to GitHub, adding it to stage changes, and I will ask GitHub Copilot to generate the commit message for me, saving time. And then I will sync the changes, which means I will push the commits to GitHub. And then if we go back to GitHub and refresh, we can see that the new dev specs folder is there already, and we can see the file that we have copied earlier. Now we're going to load this file into Bolt. In order to do that, we need to reload our project again into Bolt. Now what I'm showing you is how to bring outside changes into Bolt. Later I will show you how to get the changes from Bolt to GitHub, so stay tuned for that. So now we can see here that the dev specs file is already there, but I cannot simply drag it from Bolt, so I have to drag it in our chat window here. So I will ask Bolt to create the core layout components based on the attached specs, and we can see here that Bolt is creating the requested components. We can even check it one by one. There's the layout, the tutorial container, the navigation bar, the progress tracker. We have an issue here, but we can clear that since it's working. Now I'm going to show you how to automatically capture the changes from Bolt and push it to GitHub. So I'm going to paste some files in our GitHub repository here in Cursor. This is a script that will sync the changes from Bolt to our GitHub repository. You can find the link for it in the video description. Now let's go to Bolt, and then I will download the project using the download button here. Then I will drag that file into the folder of our Git repository. But first, I have to make sure that the script is running. So now the script is watching for any zip files loaded in our Git repository folder. So now let me drag the zip file that I have downloaded earlier. And if we go back to the terminal, you can see here that it automatically extracted the files and commit those changes, and then finally it will delete the zip file. Actually, it will move it in some folder, in this case the Bolt sync folder. So it will continue to watch for any new zip files. If we go back to GitHub and refresh, we can see that there's a commit just now. So this is the commit where we have added the components we requested Bolt to create. So now our cycle is complete. Now we can continue using Bolt to generate the other components. After this change, we will reload Bolt again to clear our chat history. Now let me download the project zip again and drag it to our folder, and watch the script automatically push our changes to GitHub. We can continue working on the rest of the components here, so I will speed up the rest of them. Let me just quickly check GitHub to make sure that it's syncing our changes. Yes, we can see those commits in there. So our script and our development cycle is working perfectly. Now that we have generated all the components, I will ask Bolt to check if all components has been generated as per the specification file. So we can see here that it's checking our project files and checking if all the components has been generated, and it says that everything has been generated. This is the end of the first part of this video series. In the next video, we will continue developing our project using Cursor and Cline. So stay tuned. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to subscribe and like, and hit the notification bell. Thanks for watching. Happy coding!